printed papers in people's rooms, that's only going to last about 3 days. I'm sure people are tired of doing that. So I think this television thing is kind of cool and opens a lot of opportunities. So technologically, it sounds stressful, but if you can get someone to help you set it up, it sounds like it opens up a whole giant door of stuff to do.
Right. Okay. Thank you. I'm just kind of going down the, well, I don't know how it looks on your screen. There's a lady, her video just says iPhone and she's in a white shirt. There's no name listed. I can't tell.
That's Carol from New Jersey.
Oh.
Carol Pezzle.
Hey, Debbie.
Carol, what's going on? Do you have any advice, anything that's working or not working?
Well, I'm actually on vacation this week. So I haven't been to my building, but I work in AL and we are still doing activities. Actually, we're not in, the residents aren't in their rooms or anything. So everything seems to be going well and we're doing social distancing as well as we can and trying to keep everybody's spirits up.
Okay. Thank you. Dion Rose.
Let's see. We started Friday, not letting visitors in. I've been doing the packets. They've been going down with the coffee cart. They really love having the coffee and the cookies being passed out and doing pretty much one-on-ones for right now. Trying to come up with, we have Touchtown. It's an in-house television station. It does live stream YouTube, and we got going today practicing doing services in the chapel to see if they could view the church on Sunday at 3 o'clock. And it does seem to work.
I can tell you in regards to Zoom, there's also a, not Zoom, YouTube. In regards to YouTube, there is a live feature that you can utilize. So if you're already tapped into your residence rooms through this system that you have, you can go on YouTube and do the live option, and it would be the same thing as what we're doing now. So you could do things such as bingo with them. You could do exercise with them, all those things.
Yes.
So just keep that in mind. That might help you out.
Thank you. I do have a question. Does anybody have, trying to think, answers or what you're doing on the dementia units? Because there's no way you can keep them 6 feet apart.
That's a hot topic right now. do we have any pros in regards to this topic at the moment? Because that seems to be a very hot thing. And we've posted a thread on the NCAP Facebook page to try to get ideas. But is there anybody on the call that is having some success with some things that you're doing in regards to wanderers and Alzheimer's and memory care units?
That would be a no.
I wonder if you were to give them like sensory stuff that they could keep, that would be helpful, like things they could do with their hands. And then it's going to be really hard to keep them contained because the building that I just worked in the Reading, Pennsylvania area, there was just people who they just wanted to wander and walk. And so that's going to be a really kind of tough one. I did share on Facebook last night in many of the groups information from a doctor in China, what they did with dementia residents, patients across different care settings in China. They had some good things, but I think even in China, they ran into some of the same problems with some of the dementia people trying to keep them contained and in one area. And one thing that they said as they were quarantining people in their rooms and even hospitals, they got more confused. They saw increased behaviors. So any of these places that are saying that activity staff is not essential, we are so essential right now because we can help foster routine and consistency. I'll share more when it's my turn to talk, but I think that's one of the most important things with dementia, like anything we can do to foster routine. And I like that about TV option and the building that I consult in. As a consultant, I'm not considered, I can't go into the building right now. So no site visits. So I have to change things up. But it was like, okay, that's, I'm encouraging, you know, stick with routine. And with the TV channel option, the residents can still get their favorite programs, you know, and try to keep that to that routine with those options.
Have you posted the information about what they're kind of doing in China with Alzheimer's patients on the NCCAP thread?
I did. I don't think it's been approved yet because I have, okay. haven't seen it, Brian. But I posted it in rec. Yeah, I posted it in rec therapy groups. I posted it on my Facebook page, and all of the activity pages that I'm on, I posted it there as well. It's like a 26-minute PDF presentation. It was really good.
Okay, thank you. While you're talking, anything else you want to add?
Again, like being in a position of, you know, I can't just go into, you know, a building. Like I was supposed to do a site visit last week, and that was when they got word. And because I'm not like there on a regular basis, but I've been all over it. Like after we were declared the national emergency, I was looking at DOH for Pennsylvania. I was monitoring sites, and I was sending to the administrator where I consult at and where I used to work in the Reading area and other places as well to say, hey, this is coming down the pike. So I think anything that we can do to just help one another. And one thing that's striking me throughout all of this, we are coming together as activity professionals, and it's phenomenal, the support, and it makes me want to cry that we're giving one another. And my heart is like, oh my gosh, I just want to be in a building. And unless I get a job, which I'm also interviewing for positions in Pennsylvania, unless I get a job, I can't go in buildings right now. And even as I'm going on interviews, I'm being monitored, like taking my temperature, but I'm doing what I can to help. And I think we're going to come up with some innovative things as a result of this, and a new way and method for delivering programs. And maybe it will become commonplace. You are going to have those residents who don't want to leave their room, even when we're not on quarantine. But hey, what would be wrong with streaming your bingo game so that they can also participate? So no matter how long this lasts, you know, I think we're going to come up with some new things. But I think we need to be on top of things too. I was in panic mode because I wasn't able to get a hold of the activities director where I consult at. I tried her all weekend. I couldn't get a hold of her Monday. So then I pulled out all my resources and got a hold of the one person, and she immediately called me because I'm like, and we talked for almost an hour. I'm like, there's a lot we need to talk about. So there's a lot we need to think about. Like one question that's on my mind is manicures. I don't think they should be happening right now. What is anybody's thoughts on that?
I agree.
I had that thought. Hands.
What?
You're touching hands. We're not.
You're touching hands, and even if you have the mask on, like your clothes, and so I'm probably going to send an email to the administrator and DON, and going to say it's my recommendation that at this time, you know, manicures aren't happening. And I told her the activity instructor last night. I told her, I said 6 feet away. You have to be 6 feet away when you're doing your one-on-ones.
And I don't.
Good deal.
Sorry.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Well, thank you for that. Thank you for sharing. Teresa Milleron, you're mute. You're muted. Let me unmute you. Maybe. Well, you might have to unmute yourself. It's not letting you.
Okay.
There you go.
Okay.
You got anything you can add, anything successful that's going on in your facility?
Well, I'm in Illinois, and I'm an activity consultant also. So I have not been allowed in the majority of buildings that I go to. I did talk to one of the administrators today, and I've been sending out tons of resources for all the activity directors and staff to get through it. And they did try the overhead bingo today, and some overhead trivia. And she said that did help out today.
Okay. Do you think they can utilize the connecting to the residents' rooms via the options that we've listed? Is that something that you maybe can share with them?
You know, I did share that with them, and we need to try and figure out how to make it work. Yeah.
I think it's such a wonderful thing that we have available. I know everybody's are different. If you have satellite TV versus cable TV, but I promise that the option is there. I'm pretty tech savvy when it comes to these things, and there is a way in. It may be that they have to contact their cable provider and say, hey, I need to know which channel is empty. Can you send a tech guy here to show me which box it is? But if you all have 30 channels, if you have regular TV or direct TV and you have 30 channels, there are 30 boxes somewhere in your facility. I promise. You just have to figure out where it's at.
I'm sorry. I appreciate this webinar because now I have a better understanding of it, so I can explain it to them now how to do it.
Good.
Brian, can I say something about the whole TV thing? Because all the postings are about hallway bingo and doing it over the PA system. And I think, you know, calling out numbers over the PA is just adding to the chaos of the home in some ways. That when Dawn talked about doing the bingo through the TV, she said all the interdisciplinary staff got involved because the residents, when they got a bingo, were like shouting bingo out their door. And the staff would like run up to the nurse's station to call down to the activity department and say, we got a bingo. So, you know, I think it's going to kind of pull not just activities together, but the whole building is going to kind of like, you know, everybody's looking for some solace. And I know bingo may not be a good example, but I just think it's an opportunity to get the team involved. And the TV thing, not that I want people sitting in front of TVs all day, but it's a more quiet way to communicate.
One thing I posted on the NCAP website was to do an music idol and have your staff that can perform, whether it would be play an instrument, tell a joke or whatever, like a talent show, have them to schedule a 5-minute or 10-minute section where they come in front of your dummy Zoom laptop and they perform for your residents, and your residents, it would be like that they're watching American Idol on television, and give them a sheet that has all of the performers' names and what they're doing, and then kind of let them circle who their favorites were or their top three, and then you can award the staff members that got the top three a prize or a trophy or whatever it is, like American Idol or America's Got Talent, whatever they're calling it these days. But that was just kind of an idea that I come up with sitting here at the desk the other day, yesterday, I think it was. Let's see, Miranda. I think she's frozen. We spoke to Tanya. Nicole, with the purple bandana head wrap. She's frozen. Deborah Smith. You may have to unmute yourself. There you are.
Here I am. Hi, I'm from Port Washington, Wisconsin, and I'm a life enrichment specialist for a building in Grafton. We have two memory care neighborhoods, assisted living, and independent communities. And I personally, myself, am not in the building. I have been on a leave of absence for a knee replacement, but I am the Milwaukee Area Activity Professionals Group President. I'm on the RAP board, part of the government relations. I'm the government relations chair. So I've been the last, month, been just scouring the internet and keeping abreast of everything that's been going on.
Okay. Well, hopefully, I saw that you reposted some things that we shared, and thank you for doing that. So if you see anything, by all means, use it with your group. Let's see. It says I have 10 minutes. Rebecca?
Can you hear me?
I can.
You can. All right. I'm using my phone, so it's new for me. So just a couple things. I have been sharing a lot of the posts on the Activity Professionals Networking Facebook page. So I've been sharing a lot of that. But one of the things I did just post that I've been asked to share with other activity directors, the host of Recreative Resources just shared a packet of 40 sheets of paper. So I did post that link on that page. There's a lot of great resources on there that is free to print. Just a couple of things that I've witnessed in the last 2 days at work. One, I've had a lack of interest in activity packets. I made enough for 50 residents and I maybe handed out 10 to 15. So a lot of people aren't interested in those right now. So the interaction is what we're noticing is best. We are working on the televised TV system. I just ordered the converter box. I'm hoping to get that by this weekend. But we do have a informative channel. So I've been putting on trivia, or right now we're doing caption this with some crazy pictures, and I'm handing out the sheets to the residents that want to participate. They're turning them in. It's new today. I've already had about 3 or 4 returned. So I'm hoping that that will be working. I also did those door handles, like at the hotel. I forgot what we called those, but you know, so they can fill
out. That was awesome. That was an awesome resource. I don't know if you all seen what she's talking about in regards to that, but we did put that on, I think I put it on the activity, on the NCAP resource page. If not, I will add that tonight. But that is an excellent idea. I think that would make them feel really special too. Feel like they're getting room service, a la carte activities.
And I actually did get that from your page, so it is there.
Oh, yeah, good deal. I'm telling you, I can't keep up with what I put on and what I haven't put on. So, but thank you for doing that.
We are doing manicures. Our DON administrator still wants us to do them as long as we wash hands with both the residents and ourselves. Obviously, we try to keep somewhat of a distance, but they do want us to still do manicures. So as of now, we are. And then the last activity that was really successful today, I am a musician, so I did hallways, St. Patrick's sing-along. So I went, our hallways are set up absolutely crazy. So we have like 3 different sections to sit in. Had them come to their doors, sang, went to the next section. And then we just sat and chit-chatted outside their hallways. And they actually came up with some ideas like hallway bowling, one resident at a time. Wash the ball in between. So there's things we're looking at. And as far as the dementia goes, we're allowing ours to wander as long as they kind of maintain that distance. So staff are assisting them with the distance from other residents, but we can't keep them in their rooms. We have at least 2 or 3 that walk all day long, and we're keeping them doing that. So okay. That's Thank all you. I have for now.
Okay. So we have 6 minutes left before it's going to shut me off. I want to just open the floor up for a second. Does anybody have a major issue that you want to talk about that maybe we can offer some advice to help you find a resolution to?
I have one quick question, or sure. Maybe for some suggestions. I'm an activity director for 2 small assisted living, 12 residents each building. And so our caregivers are majority activity people. How do I, how do I keep them excited about doing like the one-to-ones when we're focused on cooking, cleaning, and then making sure everything is sanitized? On top of that, we're asking them to sit in, spend 20, 30 minutes with the residents and be focused with them with everything else. How do we keep that movement going? Or any suggestions for that?
Anybody want to offer some suggestions? Christine, let me, there you go.
I think if they understand that we are all they have right now to help to meet their psychosocial needs. I mean, they're used to having their families, a lot of them almost every day.
Right.
So now be in this position, you know, and we, you know, become like their family, especially now, you know, doing the one-to-one visits and also providing those virtual visits. So I would do an education with them on meeting their psychosocial needs and how important that is. If you need any help with that, please let me know. I'm willing to even create a 30-minute or a 15-minute education for you. I would be willing to share, and I might even have some previous educations that I could look into.
Perfect. That would be awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Christina, if you want to, if you do have something like that you would like to share with the group, feel free to post that on that page. I think that would be beneficial to everybody, especially if they're struggling with staff trying to do everything, because we're all trying to do
everything. I will create something tonight. I will stay up all night and create something. How long do you want it? Because I don't want it to be too long.
It needs to be short. It needs to be, you know, to the point, maybe 15 minutes. They're not going to listen to or look at something for 30 minutes. Maybe 15 minutes, whatever you can cram into 15 minutes.
Okay. Yeah. And I think I have something from a previous presentation that would work as part of it. So I will do that. And do you want me to share that on the NCAP Facebook page, or how do you want me to share that?
Yeah. Just put it on the page. Yep. Okay. Thank you. Well, we have 3 minutes remaining of the group for tonight. I am going to say that I'm going to do this every Tuesday night from 8 to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, because I know it is very important. We are all learning, and as we go along, we'll continue to learn and grow from all of this that is happening out there in the field. I know I didn't get to everybody, but feel free to message me if you have anything that you want to ask, if you have suggestions, if you're having issues. We are trying our best to answer every single thing possibly with the time that we have. There's a lot. It is a lot. But we are working on it very diligently and as quickly and as possible as we can. The NCAP board, the NCAP team is here for you all. We are very grateful for everything that you're doing out there in the field. You all are the experts. We are learning from you all as you all are learning from us, and we're just all learning from each other, and that's what it's about. And I've got 2 more minutes. From myself, and Debbie can say this as well, we thank you. Thank you, thank you. And take some time for you. Remember to breathe. It is so important just to breathe. You know, before you go to work, before you go get out of your car, just take a minute in complete silence in your car and breathe before you go in. When you come out of the car, out of the facility to go home, before you get out of the car, take a few minutes to breathe before you go inside your house. It is so important, okay? Debbie, you want to say anything additional? No. John, anything additional? No. I can't tell
who else is on the call. No, I just think, you know, we keep working together. We can do anything because we are activity professionals.
That's right. You all are coming up with some amazing things, I tell you right now. So when we get put under pressure, it's like, It's crazy how we react when we get put under pressure, and how the creativity just explodes in us. So just keep taking all the negative, turning it around, and make positive things out of it, because you are phenomenal. Well, I'm going to end the call. Got a few seconds left. Thank you all for your input tonight. Please make sure you put this on the calendar for next week,
Tuesday
at 8 o'clock, and we'll go from there. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thanks, Brian.